I don't know if Dorcas is online, and we're also looking there at Mrs. Tasha Rustoff from Quality and Assurance. So very welcome to the lead personnel, and thank you for trusting us as facilitators again for hosting then this 2 weeks course. Further to my colleagues, my senior colleagues, Laureen and them, I've got senior colleagues here, and then my other colleagues and newcomers, very welcome here. And to the newcomers, don't be stressed out. We were just joking. It will be fine. And as the problems arise, you don't have to worry about it. We have competent.
Sorry for the confusion, please.
We just need everybody to mute, or can one of the administrators just mute the system totally for us? And then we'll be fine. Thank you for that. And then very welcome to your colleagues. You've got some excellent people that's going to work with you. Even acting judges, you're an acting judge, right? You've been adjudicating on the bench. Are you permanent now? Well, in any event, you've got some excellent people that's going to take you through the next 2 weeks, and to all the newcomers, we are there for you. Very welcome to our colleagues. And then the important people, of course, the delegates, the candidates, you are the important people. That's why we are here. We are here to take your hand and to on a practical simulation of civil litigation on the action procedures and application procedures to take you through the next 2 weeks. And this is fun. This is tough. This is hard. Firms get into each other's faces, and it's going to be very exciting. So just a couple of things I want to say. I want to be brief. I don't want to be too long, because I want the facilitators to get to their teams. I myself are only a facilitator. I'm not in control here. Don't get the wrong idea. I'm just making this introductory speech. I'm just a normal guy like all the other facilitators. Don't get the wrong idea. And I'm also not the most senior person here on the panel. So please, just don't get the wrong idea about who I am. I'm just a normal guy with my firms. Just asked to make the introduction. This is a very exciting course, as I've said. Who received docs? Let's quickly talk about that. I mean, the civil litigation action application procedures we're going to take you through. We have made some documents available. They were made available around 5 o'clock. And what we did here is we only made the facts and certain relevant documents available to the candidates. And we made all the documents available to the facilitators. There's a good reason for that. The facts are the facts, and everybody can relate to the facts, whether you're on the one side or the other side. But when we look at the plaintiff's case and the applicant's case, the plaintiff defendant's case, the applicant respondent's case, and their strategies, instructions, then obviously that's up to the facilitators. Every facilitator has to decide when and how he's going to be giving it out, because obviously we're starting with you opening your firms and it's not relevant yet. So 5 o'clock, that's now a couple of minutes ago, only the facts of the cases were made available, a combined summons, a notice of motion, and a strategy sheet. That's all. That's all. And that's the way we have been discussing the whole week, because Mr. Malema was whipping us with a whip there to get us in line. So that has now been done. That's the documents and how they've been made available. And the facilitators, in their own discretion, will take this further. They will decide, yeah, they want to run their show. And that is the way it is. Some of my docs were circulated. That's just an example to some of your colleagues that is new, but every facilitator is in control, and they know, especially the old timers, they know how they've done it, and that is how it will go down. Evaluation process all needs to work together. Guys, I want to make a serious call about upon everybody. Every time we do this course, these 2 weeks, there's always one or two people that's lacking behind or not cooperating with the team leaders and the firms. Please, guys, everybody must cooperate, because at the end of the two weeks, we as facilitators have to sit down and do evaluation, and then we have to allocate a certain assessment mark to the firms. And what I've done in the past in my teams, I have team leaders in confidence report who is not bringing their part to the table, and I report that to the administrators. Sukiswa in this case, and then they will take it further. Everybody must do their part. I'm not talking about people that's got the logistical problems, electronic problems. That you can take up with the administration division, and they will help you there. So that's important. That's important for me to say. Everybody must cooperate. Remember one thing. You're going to work in a firm, and everybody is not going to like everybody. Characters are going to clash, and you must overcome that. All right. So that's the one thing I wanted to say there. Let's see, what's there? One link. Guys, we have one link. Oh, I'm so happy about that. We've got one link. One link for 2 weeks, yes. And that link stays open. When you work with me, we go on 1,700 hours. The other people has their discretion, yeah, they're going to do it. But my link stays open for 3 hours. It's a virtual classroom. And you will receive a time slot as you are walking into my classroom and out, and as we're taking you through this. So we have one link. You don't have to worry about multiple links. You use this link for 2 weeks. Boy, that's the best way of doing that. I'm telling you, we used to use multiple links in the past, and that's where we really stressed out and people couldn't join us. One link, I'm very happy about that. It's a virtual classroom. You come and go, we stay. Other facilitators might do it differently. I don't know what they're going to do. That's how I do it. All right, there's the time slots. Time slots will be, I presume, be made available to you. My time slots will go out after the team leaders has been appointed. So we're going to go, for example, into Advocate Clark's link and the other people's link. When I'm finished here, you can immediately go to the link where all the facilitators will talk with the whole group, their whole group, before they will go into independent dealings with the firms, how they've been broken up by the administration division. So when I'm finished here, you just access that link, and that link, we're going to talk further with you. And one of the things I know that I'm going to ask you is immediately a team leader and a deputy team leader, which is actually a senior director of the firm, et cetera, et cetera. And then my secretary is here, she's working late tonight. Immediately per email, as you indicate to me who's the team leader, I've got the emails here. I'm going to send you an email with my itinerary and tonight's itinerary, because tonight's itinerary is a little bit unique because I've got a half an hour here. And then from tomorrow, the time slot itinerary will be the same until the last day or 2 days after the 2 weeks when we're going to do arguments. And every facilitator will do their own thing. Every facilitator in the discretion is the boss of their own group, and they will deal with you. Yeah, they've done it. Yeah, old dogs, we all have different ways, and the new guys on the block will find their ways. So that's about the time slots and how this is going to operate. And please, guys, this is important. If you accept leadership, yeah, you must understand that's a very responsible role, because we're teaching over a webinar. We absolutely trust you to keep the group together, and that's why I and my teams also put up a deputy leader, because I've seen that work. If there's problems, there's data problems, or the team leader is not available, then she would usually phone or get in connection with the deputy, and nothing, there's no time delay, because in the next 2 weeks, one of the things that's going to happen is we're going to be extremely busy. And you're going to be busy until 2-3 o'clock the morning, literally 2 weeks nonstop with 1 week in between you can rest. I mean, this is practical. This is the real thing. This is as real as it gets, working with us and then doing what has to be done so that by the end of the 2 weeks, we can positively assess what you've done. Please, guys, no changes in the groups. You have been put in a group. You've got to stay in that group. We've had people running around and then we can't find them. And then at the end of the day, we've got to make special arrangements. I know that Zukiswa was not going to tolerate that. You've been put in a group. You stay in that group. And one of the things you have to understand is you have to get along with people. Because sometimes people run away from character clashes. Don't do that. So please, guys, you must stay in your group. It creates a big problem here at the end. And I know. The last time we did it was somebody I was looking for. I couldn't find him. And then suddenly there was a newcomer. And at the end of the course, we realized she walked over from another team, a big mess. All right, so please, no changes in the groups. That's very important. Guys, as far as it's my knowledge, but the most facilitators, I suppose, will talk to you. But I think this is the rule that Mr. Malema and Sugiswa has made, is that all filing of documents must be in the following morning before 10 o'clock. There's a reason for that. We are all practicing advocates and attorneys and stuff. And it might be that other facilitators will also kiss what to change theirs. I don't know. But mine is 10 o'clock. You have to submit your documents by 10 o'clock on Doxit. And I have now, the last week, I've worked on Doxit. I have familiarized myself with Doxit. In the beginning, I was very negative. When we had a training, that first 10 minutes, I thought, oh boy, this dinosaur is going to have to get away from this. This is not going to work for me. But it's so easy. And we've gone so far with Doxit as we, for the facilitators now listening, to be able to sign off physically on the documents that we've seen it. So Mr. Malema knows we have done our jobs, and actually to make notes in red or blue or whatever color you want to do it. And if the facilitators, any of the facilitators have a little bit of a problem with this, please reach out to Zukiswa or Mrs. Rustov, and she will quickly show you how to do it. Because all we as facilitators need is to be able to access, go through the work, and sign it off and write a few remarks, etc., etc. Remarks are not that important because we will give feedback every day as we progress through the 2 weeks. But I'm now absolutely pro-Doxit. I'm so pro-Doxit, I went on it myself. I couldn't believe it. So you've got to file before 10 o'clock, especially with me the following morning. And then I will give instructions on merging. Don't merge documents if your facilitator hasn't told you to do it. There's a reason for it. Your facilitator has to check your documents every day. And if you merge your documents every day, then that's problematic. So they will come at a certain stage as the plaintiff or the applicant, and they will say, right, merge. And then you merge. Because at the end of the day, at the end of 2 weeks, actually, strictly speaking, there will be two global merges of two documents. And that will be the final product, the way I'm interpreting at this stage. I might be wrong. That's the way I'm looking at it. So just follow your facilitator. They know how they want things done. And within this discretion, they do as they wish to get you to 2 weeks and to bring you to the highest level of what we are trying to achieve here. All right. So that's that about Doxit. Doxit is very easy. If you have a problem with Doxit, the team leaders, whatever the other guys are, reach out to administration. It is important that if you have a problem with Doxit, that it's immediately addressed. We cannot hear about problems from Doxit 3 or 4 days from now. Because obviously, you're going to be filing as soon as within the next hour and a half from now, up to tomorrow, 2-3 o'clock. So please, guys, get that under control, and we will then be fine there. All right. Just 1 second. I received a note here. All right. Tasha and Zukiswa, they are hearing everything what we are saying. But I cannot access. A lot of you are asking questions. It's just waiting for IT to help them. But on our side, we are good. All right. All right. So everybody knows who Zukiswa and Tasha's emails is. Zukiswa, ZU. Well, I'm not going to give Zukiswa's email. Everybody knows that, because for you to be on this course, you know what Zukiswa's email is. And if you're looking for Zukiswa, please, for Tasha, you can just ask there. But I don't think you'll be looking for Tasha. So just reach out to Zukiswa if you have a problem. All right. I'm not going to take that further than that. They'll get it sorted out on their side. Some reason there's a problem, but we are not having a plumber. I think we're doing fine here. And then, of course, guys, the team leaders and the senior directors, there's a big, big obligation on you to make certain that all the members in your firm is participating. You have to delegate. And you have to make certain, and if there's a problem with people that's not pulling their weight, like I said in the beginning, you have to report it to your facilitator, or you can report it directly to Zukiswa, but always CC your facilitator, because this is the person working with the firms, and they need to know if there's somebody not pulling the weight, so they can also interact. We're all positive people, we're all people that motivate, we're practicing people currently in practice, and we know what the pressures are out there. All right, guys, I cannot think of anything else. That's about it. We're going to get into civil litigation action procedures and motion and application procedures, and we're going to run this through for you for 2 weeks, and we're going to have fun, and you're going to get into each other's hair, and you're going to be aggressive, and you're going to be attacking each other, and we're going to see your brilliance. The only thing I'm asking you at this stage, I've seen in the past that people use derogatory language in letters, etc. They get upset with each other. And the only thing I want to say here, we are professionals. When you attack each other in these action procedures and the application procedures, remember we have a code of conduct and we must act professionally. So that's very important to me to bring under your attention. And that's about the size of that. All right, I'm going to do something. There's about 15 minutes left. I'm going to do something else. I have now made the introductory speaks, but I'm going to ask the old timers, Laureen and Elsie and Kyle. I'm still not sure about the name there, but I, I'm going to ask them if they want to say something. Laureen, is there anything you want to add to the delegates?
Hi, James. Hi, everyone. No, I just want to say welcome to everyone. And yes, it's going to be hard work, like James says, but it's not difficult work. You must just do the work and be diligent about it. So you can all do it. It has been done before. Just come to class. And if you don't know, ask. That's all I want to say.
Thanks, Laureen. Elsie, what about you? Is there anything you want to add to what I've said and Laureen has said?
No, I just wanted to say welcome to everyone. I mean, the exercise looks intimidating because of the numbers, but I think if everyone, you know, plays along, like you've said, James, we are going to go into the smaller groups. So everyone is doing what they're supposed to. This is not going to be frustrating. So it's going to be a very fun exercise. And at the end, everyone will see the full benefit of, you know, the instructions will be thrown at you, will be a lot. But at the end of the day, you will see that you will have learned so much within a very short space of time. Yeah. Thank you, James.
Thanks, Elsie. And then Kyle, I think it's Kyle. Kyle, please help me, right? I apologize. I've never met you. You're also one of the four. Is there something you want to say?
Hi, yes, it is indeed Kyle, Kyle Kitzman. Other than welcome to everyone, I don't think there's much more that I can add. Besides that, I'll be seeing my group at 5:30 and good luck to everyone.
Thank you very much, Kyle. And then I will not forget your name again. My sincere apologies. That's then it from the four old timers. And then in the future, all the newcomers now will also be old timers. And the last thing I want to say is you're going to leave the site now. The introduction is finished and you can immediately access the other link to go immediately into the group and wait there. And what I'm going to do is I'm not going to go away. My group can access the secondary link immediately, which is the final link for 2 weeks, and we can start immediately. Let's leave the site and let's get down to business. Guys, good luck. And yeah, we want to see your brilliance.
Thank you and bye-bye.
Thank you, bye.
Yeah, thank you, bye-bye.
Guys, can I ask? What
we are listening
that haven't been placed under any group?
Well, I'm just a student, but then I'll attempt answering you. Have you checked your email? Because there, you already checked your email. Have you seen some groups there?
Okay, send me an email. I will respond.
I'm just a student. I'm asking whether you've seen the groups in your email.
No.
Send me an email. What's your surname?
Maybe I should.
Okay, the one that says he or she doesn't know which firm she belongs to. She must send me an email.
So this one, I did send you an email.
Send me an email. What is your surname?
Matemana.
Matemana.
Yes.
Okay, I will check for you and I will send you a list.
Hi, Zukiswa.
Zukiswa, I also don't have a group. My surname is Siliga.
Siliga.
Okay. Yes. Siliga, as in S-I-L-I-G-A.
Okay.
Hi, Zukiswa. Hi, me. I also sent you an email.
It looks like you placed me in
two groups, so I just wanted to confirm which one I should be placed upon.
What's your surname?
Mkondo.
Mkondo.
MCM.
Okay, which groups?
You have me under F and under E.
So, then the facilitator?
Mapula, I think.
Okay. Okay, yeah. Which firms?
C and E.
C. What am I saying?
It says E and...
E and what?
E and G. And G. E.
Okay, go to stay on FEMG. Ne? I will remove you from FEMG, from FEMI.
So I must stay on FEMG.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. And then so
is it still the same?
Yes,
it's the same thing.
Siliga. Go to FEMI under Mapu. Under Mapula, ne?
Okay. Okay, so under Mapula.
Yes. I will update the list and then
okay,
send
thank you. Thank you.
Hi, Zugiswa.
Yes.
This is Sibeko. I also don't have a group allocated.
Sibeko Azola.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Azola.
Hi, Zugiswa. Hi, Zugiswa.
Wait. Let me deal with Azola first. Azola, please join Sivuisi Wendlondlwana's group.
Okay, which one is going
to? Join FEMI.
FEMI, all right. Thank you, ma'am.
Yes. Okay.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm Mr. Chikalanga. I don't have a group, Mr. Chikalanga. Chikalanga, T-S-H-I-K-A-L. A-N-G-E. Chikalange.
Okay, Chik.